Good morning, Wanda Faye here. It is about 6:20, almost 6:25 a.m. Pacific time, Saturday, May 19, 2018. Hope you're doing well out there. There was just a royal wedding over in England. And let's get into the word here. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you, God. The Lord reigneth. He is clothed with majesty. The Lord is clothed with strength, wherewith he hath girded himself. The world also is established, that it cannot be moved. Thy throne is established of old. Thou art from everlasting. The floods have lifted up, O Lord, the floods have lifted up their voice, the floods lift up their waves. The Lord on high is mightier than the noise of many waters, yea, than the mighty waves of the sea. Thy testimonies are very sure. Holiness becometh thine house, O Lord, forever. Father, we lift up the situation in Santa Fe, Texas, yesterday, the horrible massacre of people, children, and this evil act of violence and evil against these people. Father, we lift up the loved ones that are grieving right now over the situation. We pray for your comfort. We pray, God, against these shootings in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind them and we come against them in the name of Jesus Christ. We lift up people that have such rage in their hearts. Mental illness, rage, evil, sin, whatever. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We pray for conviction right now, God. And we pray, God, you'll tie the hands of the enemy from these things in the future. We bind them in the name of Jesus. We take authority over school shootings, workplace shootings. We take authority over these things in Jesus Christ's holy name. Won't you come in agreement with me, please? Won't you just come in agreement with me and say your amens and bind whatsoever is bound on earth shall be bound from heaven. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Lord. For those that want to criticize prayers and thoughts and prayers and, oh, they're, you know, your prayer's not cutting it. Well, are you praying? Are you praying? For those that want to criticize prayer, are you praying? Are you reading your Bible and finding out what power you have in the name of Jesus Christ to bind and to loose safety upon people and to pray for safety for people? Maybe we need more prayer, not less. And so there's a lot to, that can be said about all these things, Father, but I'm here to pray, and I'll bind these things every single day if you want me to, Lord. Just like terrorism, we bind terrorism in the name of Jesus Christ. We bind airplane accidents in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm sorry, but the Bible says, whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound from heaven. What do those words mean to people? What do those words mean to me? They mean that I can pray and bind and it shall be done. When he comes back, will he find faith on earth? I know the Bible talks about in the last days, in the last days. Yes, in the last days. So let's don't make this into a gun confiscation, gun thing, okay? There's going to be bad things happening in this earth, and especially in the last days. The days will get more evil. But for those of us that believe in God, in Jesus Christ, the day will shine more and more for us, okay? That's the way the Bible says it's supposed to be, okay? I know. We live in a fallen world. Okay, so I just pray everybody will calm down and be at peace. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Don't panic. Stop. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. As we forgive those who trespass against us. Gotta forgive every day, people. I mean, it's a continual forgive, 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 and bless. Bless your enemies. And Lord God, I just thank you, Father God. Help parents teach their children right from wrong. In this day and age, it's like you can't even talk about spanking your kids because it's not politically correct. But we were all born into sin. We were all born sinners. We've all got the potential to do evil, okay? And sometimes the evil that we do, we don't even know we're really doing evil. And so I pray for conviction, because conviction is good, Lord. You didn't come to condemn. Jesus, the Bible says Jesus didn't come to condemn. There's a difference between condemnation and conviction, okay? There is a difference. God is not condemning you, okay? God came to save you, not to condemn you. God is love, okay? Out of his love, out of a parent's love, they will say, stop. Stop. Don't run in front of that car, child, little two-year-old. Stop it. Stop right there. Stop. They'll yell at that kid to stop him from running into the street, running into the street to get run over by a car. That's what conviction is. And so for all the love that was going out today at the wedding, at the royal wedding, love, 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 love. How about some of that Hollywood love? The hypocrisy of the hatred of our president. I mean, just think about it, okay? I'm so glad Hollywood got some religion today by the preacher, by the black preacher. Huh. I think it's funny. It's great, okay? So why don't you take that hypocritical love and put some love on our president? Because he just went through a year of hell. And those around him that support him, those that voted for him, we had a right to vote for him. And we're happy for you. You had your 8 years of President Barack Obama. We didn't dislike him because of his color. You guys, you people twist everything, you liberals, you Democrats, okay? I'm not talking about the people that don't understand politics and how vicious and vile and evil the Democrats are. I'm praying for the Democrats that you'll come back. You'll come back from the black hole you walked down. Whensoever. And the devil is behind that, okay? It's all, the devil is behind all of it. But we are supposed to be human beings responsible for our actions, okay? I had an abortion when I was really stupid, and it was evil, and it was murder. God has forgiven me. So I can speak on behalf of a sinner, the greatest sinner, okay? I can speak on behalf of a sinner because I was a sinner saved by grace. He redeemed me and began to work in me and show me right from wrong. And I was raised by good parents that showed me right from wrong, but I went astray. You might have looked at me in high school and thought, well, she must be a Christian because she don't do no wrong. She's just like Lily White. No, I wasn't. I had no idea. I wasn't saved. I went to church as a little girl, but they didn't lead me to Jesus to say the sinner's prayer. I'm sorry. Go to my webpage at newsandprayer.com and click on pray right there in the middle on the top. And yes, there's a world tracker, but we're all being tracked, okay? So don't be afraid of all that stuff. Live your life out in the open. Who cares, okay? We're all being watched. We're all being investigated, according to what I know now. So just live your life before God Almighty and do the best you can and be happy. And don't worry about it all that. Because God's dealing with the deep state, the part that needs to be dealt with. We had no idea. And if Obama had a plant in President Trump's campaign, shame on him. All et al. Hillary, you know, you might think you might look at me and go, well, she's a preacher. I'm not calling myself a preacher, but she talks about the Bible on one hand, and then she looks mean and she talks mean. Yeah, I'm pissed, okay? Because God's pissed. Excuse me. Forgive me, Lord, for saying that word. But this political correctness stuff is going to stop. Because God's going to have a white church, not white as in race church, when he comes back for us. People that are truthful to him. But he gets right down into the crevices of our lives. And the longer we know him, the more responsible we are. If we're being hated, we got to forgive, okay? If we're being hated by people, okay, I forgive you. Bless you. Because, you know, you're going to need the blessings of the Lord to be safe. And God, you know, you said in your word, you reign on the just and the unjust. We're all guilty before him, and he loves us all. He loves us all. And so we just come to you right now, Lord, and thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your mercy and your grace. And thank you for Prince Harry, Lord. When Princess Diana died, and I grieved and wailed for days because I loved her. Is it okay if we have a few princesses in our lives, like our First Lady Melania, our princess? Isn't it okay if we have beauty in our lives? A flower? You know, God bless her. I come against kidney disease in Jesus' name. I come against evil, the evil. The devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But I came, Jesus said, that they might have life and life more abundantly. The devil took my mother at 41 of cancer. I come against cancer. I come against sickness and disease in Jesus' name. I come against these shootings. We come against car accidents. Anything that is painful and hurtful, God doesn't like that. And we, as God's church, are responsible to pray. He said, if my people who are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked way, it's time to quit playing church. Okay, people? It's time to quit playing church. Every single week, every single day. Oh, Lord, set us free, God. I'll loose the book of Galatians on your body, on the body of Christ. And these priests down in Brazil, is it? They're all volunteering to quit? Clean up the whole church, Lord. Clean up the Catholics and the Protestants and the independents and the Republicans and the conservatives and the liberals and the Democrats and the whites and the blacks and the Asians. Clean us all up, Lord God. Clean us all up, Father, in the name of Jesus. We come before you right now. Humble ourselves before you and pray and turn from our wicked ways. Thank you, Father God, for this world that you made. Thank you for sending Jesus. God, our Father, thank you for sending your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to die for the sins of the entire world. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are our helper. You're our counselor. You're our teacher. You are our teacher. Yes, you've given us pastors, teachers. You've given us churches to go to, and thank God for them. But you are our king. We have a king, people. We have a king in heaven. We love you, Lord, and we thank you for England. We thank you for the royal wedding today. There's nothing wrong with watching royalty and beauty, but we're all royalty in Christ. We're all kings and priests, little k. We're all kings and priests and ambassadors for Christ. Read the Bible and find out who you are in Christ, okay? And don't throw out the baby with the bathwater. The Old Testament's great too, because Jesus was right there. When we say the Lord's Prayer, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want, Jesus is right there, because he's the great shepherd. And we lift up Jews to you, Lord, Jewish. The Jewish people. God came for Jesus came for you first. And Israel, a place where Jewish people can go and live. And there's other people there too, Lord. Break down the walls of division. We come against Hamas in Jesus' name. We come against the wiles of the devil in every country in the world. And every leader and every little child, Lord, that the enemy is trying to take off this earth. We come against abortion in the name of Jesus. We bind it on earth. It shall be bound from heaven. Forgive us, Lord. Father God Almighty, touch the children, the unborn in the womb. And protect them, Lord. We know there might not ever be a law that changes back. And so touch the children in the womb. Touch the hearts and the minds of people. Help people, God Almighty, just do the right thing. And thank you for your forgiveness, because we live in this fallen world, Lord God. And it is difficult. It's hard living. And Father, when things hit people from left field, from the enemy that try to take them down, like mental illness, Lord, heal the minds, heal our minds and our hearts, and help us to just trust you, Lord, in everything we go through in life, and help us, Father, from day to day in our daily living, God. We love you and give you all the praise and glory. Bless everybody's day out there with joy and peace and love. Protect, bless marriages and children and businesses, Father. Bless our president and Melania with healing, Lord God, and bless them, Father, and protect them all the days of their life. And all of the people that are helping him in our government, Lord. And help Hollywood. Raise up people, Lord God, to make the movies you want to make. I mean, you know, there's some great movies out there. Yesterday I was watching Salt. It's a good movie. There's so many great movies, Lord. Raise up the people that you want to make movies, to help them make the movies. And bless some of the old, you know, the old black and whites. They're great. We need to make some new black and whites. Okay, everybody. This was a long one. Have a great day. God bless. Bye.